Chapter 5. Joe looked at Dom and motioned him away from the old man and over to the other side of the room.
"We should go for it, Dom. Who cares if we see the guy's face or not?"
Dom agreed.
"Okay, old man, tell him it's a deal. But how do we collect? And furthermore, I ain't leaving my cross here without me."
The old man laughed aloud.
"Of course not, son. You can come back in an hour. The money will be here."
Dom and Joe agreed and left the little museum store.
"Now what?" Dom asked Joe, as if he had all the answers.
"Let's go back to where we found the cross and skull and see what else we can find, since we have a whole hour."
Dom wasn't crazy about the idea, but he went along with it anyway.
They got to the same spot in only a few minutes and got their gear out of the car.
"Hey, Joe, what are we going to do with that skull?"
Joe acted as though he had completely forgotten about the nasty-ass thing.
"Damn. I don't know, man. Maybe we should throw it in with the cross as part of the deal?"
"I'm game for that."
Dom just wanted to get rid of it. They proceeded to walk to the same spot they dug at the day before.
"Here it is." Joe squatted down and took a closer look.
"Maybe we should use the metal detector."
Dom waved the metal detector back and forth in front of Joe's face.
"Yeah, good idea."
Joe jumped up from his squatting position and grabbed it out of Dom's hand.
"Hey, why can't I do that?"
Dom was offended.
"Buddy, because I know what I'm doing."
Joe was just being Joe. Dom shook his head with disgust at his friend and walked along beside him as he waved the metal detector back and forth, trying to pick up the sound of money. The metal detector went off suddenly, not 10 feet from the original hole, and Joe yelled,
"Got it!"
He dropped the metal detector and grabbed his digging tool. "Right here, Dom. Start digging. But be careful." Dom did as he was told. They both dug slowly, though it took a lot of control to keep from digging right in.
"I see it!"
Dom was becoming very excited at just the thought of finding treasure.
"I do too."
Joe was just as excited.
"Let's smooth it out slowly and try to get a position on the depth of it."
Joe was always the practical one. Both boys ran their hands smoothly across the dirt, smoothing it away from their find until it was completely visible to the naked eye.
"What the hell is that?"
Dom was shaking his head back and forth, eyes crinkled, and the confusion was apparent on his face.
"I don't know. Looks like another skull, dude, with another cross hammered into his head."
Joe dug around it a little more, using the digging tool's flat end. He got underneath it and lifted it out of the dirt. They both sat and just stared at it for the longest time, neither one saying anything, both lost in their own private thoughts.
Joe looked at his watch. "Damn it, we gotta go, dude. It's been 45 minutes.
Joe threw the skull in the duffel bag, and they both grabbed the tools and ran for the car. Throwing everything in the back seat, they took off back to the town to the little museum store. Parking in front, Dom jumped out first.
"You got the skull?"
Joe questioned Dom before he could get too far ahead.
"No, I'm not touching that thing."
Dom was adamant about it.
"Damn it, Dom, why do I have to do everything?"
Joe was getting anxious, and he acted half nuts when he was like this.
"I don't want to touch it, Joe. I just don't. It gives me the creeps, damn it."
Dom was standing his ground, regardless of how Joe acted.
"Okay, okay, Dom. I'll be damned."
Joe reached in the back seat and grabbed the first skull they had found.
"You are going to have to get over that shit."
Joe reached for the door handle and opened the door leading to the inside of the museum.